All right, so I'm going to go ahead and drill some holes. I'm going to start with drilling a bunch of big holes, and then I'll go in and do a few smaller holes. Okay, so now I'm gonna drill some smaller holes. Okay, that's probably enough. So you can see how that looks. I'll take my razor and trim out all these little pieces too. And I'm also gonna cut a hole for the pump cord to come back through so all of it can stay together. And I probably can just drill a few more holes to the side and make a big enough, and kind of cut them out to make it big enough for the cord to go through. So let's go about the footprint there. So probably need to be on the edge. Yep, so that fits in there. So that'll be coming back up out of the top. That way everything can stay contained within this internal bucket. Also, I'm going to use a 3-inch net pot in the lid. So we'll go ahead and drill a 3-inch hole. And I'm also going to put a couple quarter-inch holes around so I can zip tie the basket in there really well. So basically what I did, just kind of roughly marked so I know where to drill a few quarter inch holes, so it'll be outside of this hole. Go ahead and drill this hole. On these, I like to start it slowly in the forward position and then switch it to reverse. And this really soft plastic, it'll cut through it okay. A lot of times, it seems like it does a cleaner cut for plastic. I know it's not proper and all, but that's how I do it. It seems to work. I learned that watching, I believe it was King Star. Okay, so now I'm going to switch it in reverse. So, 3-inch net pot to fit in there, and then I'll zip tie it really tight so the plant won't fall out. I guess one thing I can do, glue my piece in here. Glue it into one of these, put it in here. And then, okay, so basically wedge these together, but through here. So if one of these, I can go ahead and glue it in. I hope this stuff's still good, but you can get this as a, when you buy these, it's, it always comes together, but it's, one's the primer and the other's the cement. So you, primer, and this stuff may not even be good. It's been so long since I've used it. I probably need to wear gloves too. put the primer on like that. Definitely gonna wash my hands. So these are the coated parts where the cement's gonna go. This is gonna wedge into. There we go. Yeah, this stuff's still good. That in there. So let's move this one and then wedge that in like that. Probably using way too much of this stuff too. I don't really ever use this stuff. Okay. Should hold. So now I've got a point to put the pump to, and then this side will have the spray manifold. So, like that. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is clean up my mess, wash my hands, clean all this stuff, and install my spray nozzles, and I'll show how I do these and get the everything ready to go, and we'll wrap this up. See, just kind of force that in there. It will not come out very easily. There we go. Throw that in there good.